to the Bengaluru chapter of Association of Consulting Civil Engineers of India, over 95% of constructions in the city are clearly in violation of one kind or the other. The association has said that the BBMP engineers are negligent when it comes to maintenance, and hence surveys conducted by them are actually of no use. They have demanded for an Engineers Act which shall keep a check on who should audit structures and give approval for construction. The association has termed the situation within courts dangerous and has urged the government to act immediately to rectify all the flaws. And to speak more on the issue, I'm being joined by Shrikant Chanal, who's GC member of Chanman Issues and Advocacy. Shrikant, a very warm welcome to you. This is really dangerous, what we are, you know, what we are reading, you know, about how 95% of the buildings are in clear violation. So, you know, whenever, you see, every year, as I understand, Shrikant, there is a list which is sent out that, you know, so many buildings are actually very in a precarious situation, notices are sent, etc., etc. But even this year, you know, we are playing these visuals. I mean, homes have fallen like a pack of cards. Can you hear me, Shrikant?
Yes. I can hear you.
Yeah, so this 95% of buildings in clear violation, is it a clear case of corruption and a nexus?
Madam, I don't want to comment on the corruption, nexus and all those things, but the fact is that 95% of the buildings are under violation in one form or the other. That is the only fact I can tell you. The reasons and I think you are well aware of it, which I don't want to...
Okay, Shrikant, so let me ask you, how did you come to this conclusion? I mean, what were the criteria? If you say 95% of these buildings do not follow the norms, then what is the most violated norm, Shrikant?
Yeah, see, there are violation means there are many types of violations when a building is taken into account. See, for example, violation could be of many types, say setback violation, then height violation, FAR violation, then occupation violation, then number of floor violations, parking violation, safety, fire safety violations, structural safety violations. Like that, there are many violations. Even if you don't provide the garage and if you are parking the vehicle outside, that is again a violation. And if you are not doing the building as per the NBC norms, that is violation. So there are all the violations put together. You will find that around 95% of the buildings are under violation.
Hardly, you know, Shrikant, although you do not want to comment on, you know, where the buck lies or who is culpable, but clearly it is the ordinary citizen, no? I mean, people build homes, it's a dream. They save up all the money, you know, whether it is a building where children are studying, whether it's a hospital, whether it's homes. But ultimately, the common man will suffer. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, definitely, madam. They are going to suffer, and ultimately, the whole public is put into trouble. And there are reports that FAR violations were ranged from 200 to 300% earlier. By the media only, it was reported. And these are all leading to the insufficient and unhealthy ventilation around the buildings, crashing of civic amenities, and then increased air pollution reaching dangerous level as it is there in Delhi. Then the road jams are very common, and increased density is causing lot of parking problems.
In fact, Shrikant, you know, the picture that you paint is very, very grim. For a beautiful city like Bengaluru, you know, which used to be a city of gardens, a haven for the retired, today it has come to this level where most of the buildings are in violation, 95%, like Shrikant just now said, and there are various violations, parking violations. There is, so people of Bengaluru who are actually, a lot of them advise other cities and says, we are in a better shape. I wish you were in a better shape. But what Shrikant says, you are not. Thank you so much, Shrikant, for joining us on this broadcast. Time for me to take a break on Southwood Sudha, but I'm